huge playoff match between Jingbudda and BoomBoomHall, between the Ghost of Casuals and the Hairy Generals, who are currently tied in points. 8-8, I believe it is. And we're 10-10 or something like that. They're tied.
8-8.
Two matches left. This is one of them, and then Jedi Ninja versus Adam will be the other one. So if either team can win both matches, obviously they win. Otherwise, every point matters.
Yeah. I mean, as we saw with Supreme and Team Rank 5, you guys tied in points. So, yeah, points do matter. Whoever wins here, it'll be big. But if they can win with 3-1 or 3-0, then it's huge. Just massive.
Yeah,
and really
who has
putting
won the
pressure.
Majority so far?
We have.
Okay.
We have. We have 3-2s, and then Necro got a 3-0 for the Hairy Generals. So
the more convincing Jingbudda can win, the better. Well, the more convincing either player wins, the better.
Browsing the collection. All right, they're not preparing to battle yet. Yeah, and I talked about this a little bit with Jing earlier. I mean, obviously the goal is just to win, but if you can think of a few ways in your head to maybe push the envelope a little bit and get that extra mile and make the 3-1 a little bit easier, like put yourself in a situation for it.
They are preparing to battle.
Yeah.
They are discussing their bans with themselves.
Yeah. Well, Jing, I know Jing knows his ban.
Yeah, Jing. Bringing,
sure, he queued it.
Bringing Hunter, Mage, Paladin, Warlock.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I would think he's looking at banning the... Oh, maybe not even the Paladin.
All right, they're going in. Yeah, he should be banning the Hunter unless I'm...
Okay.
Unless I'm being surprised here. But yeah...
Jing is banning... Yes, he is banning the Hunter.
Oh, and Mage, okay.
And Boom Boom is banning the Mage.
All right, this makes sense. You bring Paladin, Warlock, even Druid. You worry about Mage a bit. Just all kinds of Mage. Jing is very familiar with Mage. So the lineups, they remain pretty similar. They have Paladin and Warlock in common, and they differ. Jing with Hunter, Boom Boom with Druid.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And that Hunter, I don't think is gonna struggle very hard to find a win against the classes that Boom Boom is bringing.
No, I don't think so. I'm sure Boom Boom, I don't know, probably in that ideal world may have liked to ban the Paladin, but Mage is just so flexible. We've kind of been saying it a bit lately. These versatile classes are worth getting rid of. Alright, now they're thinking it up over a little bit.
Neither player lost their Paladin, so in my mind that means you lead with your Paladin, but...
Yeah, no spoilers of inside information, but I think that's going to be seen from one end, at least.
Okay, so Jing leads with Paladin, and Boom Boom leads with Druid.
I will fight with honor.
Doesn't get too much better than this, really, but that's a nice hand that Boom Boom's got there.
It really is.
Whoa! I mean... This is bordering on first world druid problems of just too much ramp, but...
Yeah, I think I would even mulligan away an aspirant here.
Yeah. I could see that, but aspirants... Well, I mean, one's good enough. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah, not bad.
The internet. Oh, man.
It's going to start out really good, but...
And Jing is playing mid-range paladin, because we see a lay on hands in the hand. Until that moment, we had no idea what he was playing.
Right. No 2-drop hurts, especially with what I imagine will be a coin aspirant. But... Oh, man!
We found the other one anyway! Coin aspirant is just so difficult for Paladin to do anything
definitely.
To respond to.
Yes.
He's gonna play... Oh, I don't like this at all.
Well... Yeah, I don't know.
That Innervate can cheat out such a powerful card that you can draw into, and now you need to draw into a curve that you don't have in your hand yet.
Yeah, because what Boom Boom just did is he essentially ramped himself into 4 mana, because Paladin has no way to deal with these aspirants, so he's going to have 4 mana next turn, but he doesn't need 4 mana.
Mm-mm.
Reporting for duty.
But, oh!
but he finds it.
I stand corrected.
Zero punish.
I stand corrected.
And if you're the paladin, you're staring down quite the board here. Consecration will help.
Yeah, it'll be something to look forward to. Boom Boom's got no swipe. So if he takes the token seriously at all, he'll be putting himself into consecration range. If he ignores it,
and if he tosses out the shade willy nilly, he would even
hurt. Oh, that would be huge. That would be huge. I think Jing's looking to take a lot of damage, but hitting with the Light's Justice is pretty good. It signals a bit though.
Yeah, now if you're Boom Boom, I think you want to trade everything off. I think you'd even want a hero power token and use your aspirants on the other two. Because yeah, your opponent just told you he's going to consecrate next time.
Yeah, effectively. Which, I don't know, good for Jing. He takes a little damage. He avoids a little damage. He'll probably take more again. I mean, I guess he tanked.
Already finding half of the combo.
Yep. Not bad. I mean, he's going to lose tons of mana here, but it won't be a problem because Consecration's down. Shade feels safe. And that's not a bad minion at all.
Oh, and a Sludge Belcher off the top to protect it even.
Perfect. Oh, man.
Druid does Druid things.
Doing Druid things very, very well. There's nothing that feels really great here.
No, he doesn't have a clear play.
I guess Shredder? Like, you don't want to Cog Hammer up a mini bot. You'd Shredder and you hope to Cog Hammer, I suppose, or... Whew. Yeah. It's not often Druid does this well versus Paladin, but...
No, it's not.
But this is pretty much what it takes. Aspirant is... way too good for the matchup. Until Paladin gets 2 mana, 3 damage removed. Whoa.
And the other half of the combo is in hand. So now if you're Boom Boom, I think you want to start clearing off this board a little bit.
You might.
Maybe not. No, he is going to push.
Yeah.
He's already setting up so that if Jing doesn't have anything clean to do with his Cog Hammer here. Now he's just going to die to Savage Roar.
I like pushing because you saw Consecration and you didn't see a Sludge Belcher this turn. So I think Boom Boom's pretty confident that this damage will keep rolling. And even just like the naked force of nature might turn into a lethal. Wow. Is there any way
to prevent dying?
Looking at the quality, and then there's Cog Hammer, there's Keeper of Uldumon, which I don't know. I think there's going to be 7 damage on the board.
Oh, yeah. Taking 3 here.
And tanking this damage. Well, I mean, I guess you could hope that they kill Shredder and a taunt pops out of Shredder.
Yeah, and that is going to be lethal for both.
Yeah.
Either card in his hand. Oh, Swipe will do it too.
Swipe will do it too.
And he will show the top deck people.
Yeah, Swipe probably even does it better.
Oh!
Yep, there's the taunt. There's the taunt, doesn't matter. Not at all. Oof. That feels really good for Boom Boom, Boom, Boom getting the Druid out of the one.
Punishes the no Paladin banning.
Wow.
Or no. As rewarded for not banning Paladin, I should say.
Yeah, because Druid held it down. Alright, so...
Boom's now got he now has Paladin and Warlock. I think I like just going Paladin into Paladin here.
Probably. Interesting for Jing now, like, he doesn't... Now his Warlock doesn't necessarily have to be pigeonholed into Zoo, assuming he wanted to beat up on the Druid, which is now impossible. But, yeah, if you're Jing... I don't know if there's consideration for Hunter here. Midrange doesn't feel great versus Paladin. Face can be hit or miss versus Warlock. Especially if it's Reno. I wouldn't mind seeing the Paladin get thrown out again.
Paladin's just so powerful.
Yeah, it's a good class. Good cards. 34 out of 40 people brought it. This says something. Alright, versus Warlock. I'll see what kind of Warlock this is, but...
Looks like a hand lock, which is a curious bring against a mid-range Paladin.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely might.
Okay,
if only...
a Reno Warlock.
It's a Reno, yeah. Stalag is a dead giveaway.
Interesting, he got rid of the 3-drop.
Yeah, kept the Hellfire, which is good. I guess he wants, he might not Hellfire turn 4, he might want Twilight Drake, Imp Gang Boss, Zombie Chow. Oh wow, did Jing? He kept the Big Game Hunter and the Owl. Cool. That'll pay off.
Yeah, he's all in on assuming this is a hemlock.
Yeah, I think he's done a little research on Boom Boom, okay. And I think that's what was dug up. So
Boom Boom picked up the all-important end game boss, which is very nice here. It's going to do a lot of work against Jing's hand, assuming he doesn't draw into a true silver.
Right. Yeah, Imp Gang lines up decently. There's even Abusive Sergeant. There's Hellfire, which could clear everything. Muster's probably going to come down. I guess the question is, what do you do with it? You could have, like, Zombie Chow hit the Imp Gang and then kill the Imp or something. Just weaken it down. That's really what Chow's good for.
Yeah, hitting face with Zombie Chow is good.
No. Yeah, so this is fine. Now you know if you get AoE'd that, well, outside of Demon Wrath, that at least the Imp Gang's gonna go to.
I do think the Hellfire's too good to pass up.
Yeah, I think so. Like, Coin Quartermaster's possibility. Oh my god! Wow.
Holy cow.
Boom Boom is very brave here. Wow. I guess, like, Coin Quartermaster, you had Hellfire anyway, but something would be sticking. He's gonna trade at least.
I don't think so. Get as much value out of it as you can.
Wow! Keeper? That's not bad.
No, not at all.
Really? Yeah,
Lotham isn't terrible either here.
Yeah, it's true. Lotham's looking to line up against maybe a Belcher, maybe a Lotham itself. Jing knows this is a slow Warlock. Keeper of Uldumon will definitely get value in the future, but you've already got Owl, Equality, and Big Game Hunter. This is the great thing about Paladin. When you're not playing Secrets, you can play so many good cards. None may steal ours. Keeper, yeah, on the dude. A little pressure never hurts when you've got Equality to back it up. Now, if you're Boom Boom...
You have to Lotheb here.
Probably Lotheb. Like, yeah, you won't throw Stalag out. Stalag's just dead. So easily.
Oh, Stalag comes out, the game ends. There you go.
Something like that. Yeah, I mean, Boom Boom, he still has the Hellfire back there, but he'd probably like to play one of these 6-drops next turn. We'll see. There's a second turn. Honestly, I mean, Chow's on board, but if Jing plays his own Lotheb here, he could have an argument for pushing some damage himself. If spells are expensive for Boom Boom, then the only way to kill the Chow is with a 6-mana Mortal Coil or Lotheb trading. If Lotheb's trading, then he's not killing Lotheb. So. Huh. Interesting choice here. Yeah, can't be blamed for trading. Because now Lotheb will stick. Guaranteed. Hmm.
Sylvanas is a great contest. And
I have no time for games.
It's tough to play around a 1 of 9 cards into your opponent's deck, so.
Yeah, seriously. Yeah, thankfully for Jing here, he's got.
Yeah, if he didn't have the owl.
The owl, and what? He's also got equality and consecration now, so I think he could confidently.
Yeah, it's gonna be
pressure.
Very tough for Boom Boom to ever catch up with so many answers in the Paladin's hand.
Yeah, he's even got land hands to refill if he ever wants. If you're Boom, I don't know, it depends on what Jing does, but Boom Boom probably would like to play Dr. Boom next turn. I think he can, but... Huh. So Jing's, he's probably also considering Molten Giants, just thinking of all the good things in Handlock life.
Must move quickly.
I don't think there's even really no... Has there been a dead giveaway that it's Reno? I think the Imp Gang boss, yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, Heat Trades. I don't know about playing... Maybe Zombie Chow just never gets played now.
Oh, here he comes. Oh, well, maybe not. No Zombie.
If you play Chow, it's not terrible. You can just continue to control what's going on and try and draw into some of your more powerful cards. Because these are just responses right now.
Boom Boom has seen the owl. Now he's going to rage upon seeing the big game hunter.
If he has a deck tracker installed, he'll know that they were kept. Yeah, so you could do a combination of clearing off bombs, going face, playing big game hunter.
Let me think.
Wonder if Jing is... I mean, AoE's gotta be on your mind as a paladin, but he hasn't seen any yet. He has lay on hands. And the almighty valuable coin is still hanging on.
Oh, bad Boombot.
Oof. Good if your name is Jingbu. Wow. Just really doesn't matter. If the keeper could have tanked some damage, it would have been great. Because then the Hellfire could actually clear.
Put this apple on your head. Yeah, the Hellfire will clear.
Yeah.
Juggler's even gonna come down with it.
Keeper will hang around. There's no mortal coil. Yeah.
I think we'll see a Dark Bomb.
Oh, Dark Bomb, yeah, of course. And... You could even tap, really, versus Paladin. Well, you'd be putting yourself down to 5. That's kind of scary. Dead to True Silver Consecration.
Yeah, I think...
Stuff like that.
We'll just see this. He may even toss out, like, a Sun Fury Protector.
Yeah, Tempo Sun Fury. It's not bad. Boom Boom's got stuff in hand to follow up. If, say, there's a Tyrion, he has Owl, Siphon Soul. Just perfect. Maybe the Sun Fury doesn't need to be held on to. Versus Paladin, like, taunting up the big stuff doesn't always pan out.
Jingbudda Bricks, a double equality. He was targeting the Handlock.
Oh, yeah. It's good. So good for Druid, too.
I'm so curious that, yeah, Boom Boom queued in there.
Yeah.
Good lay on hands turn. He's not facing any pressure.
Now's about the time.
And he finds plenty of things to do next turn.
Yeah. For sure. No. No other weapons, but I don't know if this hit is meaningful. You probably save it. Not even coining out Zombie Chow, it's so... Ooh! Molten? Emperor. If he had hit, he may have signaled like the True Silver Consecration, which is possible, which would have really scared Boom Boom, I think. Paladin's not really known for their burst. 7 is a safe number.
Boom Boom has to be thinking about equality consecration here, too. So I think he's going to wonder how many threats he wants to toss out.
Yeah, I think so. He saw Big Game Hunter. I think he should play. Molten should get played. Maybe not. Okay. Interesting. Not bad. Oh. Pretty heads up, actually.
And wow. Jing picks up the Peacekeeper for the Molten Giant.
Yeah. Well,
I like equality, and then I think it's okay to use your face to kill this 5/5.
Sure, so one equality.
Dr. Boom as well.
The funny thing about one equality is it will probably bait Boom Boom into overextending. He won't really expect the second. I don't think many people are thinking about two equalities these days. But I like this too. Nice. Push damage. For all he knows, he might top deck Coghammer or True Silver within these 14 cards. It's like a... It's a pretty big chance, actually. Ooh, Traxxas. No big game hunter. He's got Siphon.
Yeah, he's gonna... Or he could... Oh, you don't want to give up your Emperor, though.
No. Molten... Siphon. Unfortunately, Sun Fury.
He's got Owl for Tyrion, so I don't think you need to hold this Siphon Soul.
Yeah, it's too bad. It's too bad in this situation that, like, Bran Bronzebeard's just kind of hanging out. Not really doing anything.
It didn't matter.
He's good. He's good. I think he's probably good.
He's gonna... think a Boomba.
Yeah, I think he wants to clear them and just flood the board a bit. Oh, he could have silenced that Boombot twice, you know.
Don't you ever speak to me again.
Oh my... That's brutal.
That's lethal.
Yeah, that's game. No equality even needed. He could use the top deck one if he wants. Nah. The Gosu casuals aren't quite up to date on the latest metagame of subtle BM. Alright, so, wow. Really good for Jing. He walks away with a win and lots of information. Because if you know about Reno, I mean, he must know it's a Reno build.
This that allows quite Jing to play probably a bit slower Hunter deck, too, then.
Yeah, and now he'll have a much better idea of what kind of Warlock that he wants to play. He knows that Boom Boom, he didn't queue up Zoo or anything. He never saw the Stalag. Because when it comes to Reno Lock, which I think he'll know it is, there's definitely several varieties out there.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't see the abuse of Sargent. I don't know if bells will be ringing that it's the combo or not, but he's definitely aware of all forms of Reno Lock. Because if it comes to a Reno Lock mirror where both players are playing Stalag and Fugin, it becomes very awkward in a lot of cases.
So if you're Boom Boom here, I think Paladin's the easy choice, right?
Yeah.
Assuming he has a mid-range Paladin built.
Yeah, Paladin makes tons of sense. It always
and
makes.
He goes back to the Warlock.
I was writing Paladin down on my paper because it made so much sense.
I know Jing likes his handlock. That's... So...
Yeah.
I'm assuming this is a pretty classic handlock build. Maybe some demons in there, but I don't think we'll see a Reno from Jing.
Yeah, it could be. Reno... He banned Hunter, so he's not too afraid of
sacrificial pact.
Aggression. Ah, yes. Yes, yes, yes. It's a special special
anti warlock, right? It's so good.
It's
I had one of those built for a match this season.
Oh, Andy, he has the Fugan Stalag build. Okay.
Oh, so he has Reno. Oh yeah, mind control tech.
Reno with a little sacrificial pact love built in.
Buying or selling.
Wow. Yeah, like ultimately these Reno lock mirrors or just handlock mirrors in general, they can often come down to who plays Jiraxxus first, for example.
I'd love to know what the thinking is on that Dragon Egg.
The Dragon Egg?
Yeah.
What were the options again? I saw
Reliquary Seeker, Argent Squire, and Dragon Egg. think with Implosion in hand, I think I would take the Reliquary Seeker. Or you play it safe and get the 1-1 Divine Shield. Dragon Egg? I don't know. I guess it helps against AoE. Kind of?
Yeah, I guess so. At the same time, Squire is too, but I guess in that sense, Dragon Egg is kind of better. Because after AoE, you get a 2-1. Whereas the Squire is left
really
at
like
1.
I really like the Seeker with Implosion in your hand.
Yeah. Yeah, it's totally possible that it could happen. Seeker is not easy to answer. Actually, with the Implosion, this might be funny that Mind Control Tech might actually get something done in this matchup.
Not be a good feeling Implosion, but he's going to go for it. He can't kill this Drake, so I'm not sure.
There wasn't a ton else to do except maybe coining Belcher, and maybe he wants to coin Sylvanas. Maybe. Well, do you bite on this MC tech? It's not too tempting. Fugin's good. The funny thing, I can't remember exactly what he told me, but D-Lineman told me something about this matchup regarding Fugin and Stalag and how apparently the first
one to play one
is
the worst.
Is in a bad spot. That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we played this mirror in a tournament and I was a little behind on the theory crafting that goes into it. Yeah, I don't mind the MC tech.
It begs an AoE to be removed.
Yeah.
I guess Jane could just... Belcher gets quite a bit of value on this board as it is.
If he trades into the
1-1, he's going to kill a Drake and probably eat a Mortal Coil, and that's like best case scenario for Jingbudda.
I wouldn't be surprised. I don't think coining Sylvanas is very good. I think she's getting dealt with. Well, she might clear the board herself.
I think Sylvanas Shadow Flame is so strong in this matchup that you want
to
get to it if you can.
What's also interesting about this matchup is that a card like Demon Wrath, I feel like if any player can find a point to get value off of that card, which can so often just do nothing in situations, is in a good spot. Well, if you're Jing, nothing feels... He's eyeing that Implosion, which I wouldn't mind.
No, the Implosion would help.
And tap.
He doesn't have a Mortal Coil, and he doesn't want to trade two minions into a Sludge Belcher.
Yeah, he doesn't want to part ways with this Power Overwhelming either.
No.
I think in combination with Shadow Flame for burst potential, it's so good. It's
such a good card. Yeah, here comes the Implosion.
Oh, I just realized. Yeah, he can't tap either because he's at.
He's
tap. He can play. Might as well play the Chao while they're high. Yeah. Always good to force your opponent to respond. He can coin Boom. He can play Sylvanas.
I like the Boom, personally.
Yeah, I mean... Yeah, Twilight Trick's just going to get easily traded into, I think. It'll have, what, 9 health if you tap? Or would it be 10?
It would be 10.
Yeah, even so.
He could play a 9 health Drake with an Imp Gang boss.
Oh yeah, that's true. Hanging onto the coin for a year might not necessarily pay off, but who knows with things like Draxus.
He's got a life tap. Oh, he finds Hellfire.
I think that gets played now.
Hellfire.
Yeah, in this matchup. I think so. Shadow Flames.
Players playing Brand Bronzebeard.
The big one. Oh, he's so good with Dr. Boom, but you can't wait for that. Boom's gotta come down. Maybe now's the time for Boom Boom to play the Sylvanas.
It could be.
And he can even Mortal Coil. Hang on to the precious coin. Oh, interesting. So, oh yeah, maybe.
I like the answer.
Yeah, Emperor's the one.
Because this will set up some value on his Demon Wrath, assuming he wants to use that to remove the rest of Emperor after this current turn.
Yeah. That's true, I could see it playing
out. Now, if Emperor gets Siphon Sold, Boom Boom's in a bit rougher of a spot.
Yeah, thankfully he'll have the Molten Giant in case the Boom connects to face, yeah. But that won't happen. I think Jing's had a few opportunities to play Fugue, and I wonder if he is holding back on it specifically because of suspicion. He never saw the Stalag, but I wouldn't be surprised if he just tapped and played it now, maybe. Tapping's pretty good. You didn't see BGH here, and you're getting your Molten cheaper and cheaper. Maybe he doesn't want to trade. He's got a little burst to look forward to, but you can't give Emperor two ticks. You really can't. Maybe he's thinking about playing Brand for tempo or something. Maybe he's suspecting this combo. Reno and Emperor just came down. Wow.
So Demon Wrath will get plenty of value here if he plays it.
Yeah, because with Emperor... Oh, yeah, it'll be...
Although, I think I'd like to see Twilight Drake. Oh, no, because Twilight Drake would take the damage.
Good Demon Wrath, good Hellfire this game for Boom Boom. Yeah, Jing, he might be suspecting the combo lock, because Boom Boom did just play Emperor. He has 8 mana, which makes... And along with Coin, it makes Abusive, Power Overwhelming, Faceless, and Leroy. They're all playable. I don't know if that's what he's thinking about. But we talked about the combo Reno lock a little bit earlier.
And Boom Boom just keeps presenting boards that Jing is forced to deal with.
Yeah, initially Jing was doing it himself, but the Emperor really turned the tide. Sacrificial Pact has not found anything. You won't use it on Imp Gang Boss, I don't think.
No. You want to hold that. It's really just a dead card unless it ends you. So many
possibilities. Yeah. And when it does, man, you'll look really cool.
And I think it's going to. Like, the way this game is shaping up,
both players
have so many answers in their hands that as soon as Boom Boom finds Jiraxis, he's just going to lose.
Yeah. They're even on cards left in their deck. Jing also has the slightly larger hand. And Emperor will be really good here.
Yeah, it will.
He's seen plenty of AoE. He can even play the Farseer along with it. If he wants, though, it's not doing much. If you have 2 3-3s, then maybe one of them's gonna hang around. Oh, okay. So he's hanging on to the...
That's a top deck.
There you go. He used Healbot, so he's kind of keeping the Brand Earthen combo, I think.
Oh, Boom Boom hovers over the loop then.
Yeah.
I think Siphon Soul is the best card here. But he's... Oh, I see what he's... He's going to Defender of Argus and trade into the...
Oh, yeah, that's good.
That's better than anything I saw.
Yeah, this is really strong, because Boom Boom, he didn't see an Owl. He didn't see Owl earlier when he played Sylvanas, and he didn't see it now when he played... Oh, speaking of which. Hi, Ironbeak Owl.
And so Boom Boom has 5, 10, 12, 15, 16 on board. He has no burst damage from him, so we can't kill Jing next turn.
He's also got a cheap Molten Giant, so if any huge AoE... Well, huge AoE can't happen, because Lothab has something to say about it, but... Yeah, it's a weird spot for Jing, actually. You'll probably just play these minions expecting that they'll get killed off, but then you'll have the follow-up of AoE.
Just one minion? Or is it going to throw out? Okay, Farseer. Farseer. For Big Game Hunter to hit. You can toss out the Brand. Although, he would have wanted to hit it before the Farseer, so that's not going to happen.
Probably. Yeah, at this point, I don't know how great Brand is for Jing anymore. I think he has Peddler left in his deck. It's something. Could be useful.
Now, if you're Boom Boom, you don't want to play any threats here, right? Because you have such a menacing board already.
Yeah, Boom Boom, he's played all the AoE this game. He has seen no AoE from Jing, so...
I think Siphon Souling is actually okay here, because he has the big game hunter for other threats. He could trade, too.
Yeah. You could let the board do...
Because you don't want to enable Molten Giants for Jing anyway, so... Like, trading the Lotheb and the Defender into the 4-7, and then the Gang Boss into the 3-3. You're not left with a lot of board after
Yeah, you're not. I think he'll do some combination of trades that makes him comfortable with the event of AoE.
Now, there's no circumstances where he should owl this.
I have no time for
this. No. Or if you can... Wow, so nice. Oh, wow, he goes in.
Yeah, that's refreshing. Curious.
So now,
actually, overwhelming Shadow Flame is so good right now.
You don't even need to part ways with the Power Overwhelming if you want. You can use the Demon Wrath.
Oh yeah.
In fact, you could trade Fugin into Twilight Drake. Use Demon Wrath and Hellfire. Keep Shadow Flame. A little Imp will hang around.
That Sylvanas is going to open the door for Jing quite a bit because she's not going to get any value.
No. Yeah, so you could Shadow Flame, but there's opportunities for the smaller AoEs, but I know Jing, he was healing himself a bit before. I wonder if he'll take this push differently.
He is going to Shadow Flame.
Shadow Flame and Demon Wrath.
Yeah.
Or Hellfire if he wants to get rid of everything. But yeah, just get rid of it all. Mullen Vendor. Yep.
Pretty good.
Yep. That works. Unfortunately, no Shadow Flame left, but he has Big Game Hunter and Owl.
Oh, this Fugin is so good.
Stalag, yeah.
So
right.
BGH Stalag looks like a pretty easy play here.
BGH Stalag. Yeah, unfortunately Molten won't get played. Or Dr. Boom. Wow, I can't believe... Oh, Boom Boom, he's had Dr. Boom hanging out in his hand for a while, just because he had the board these last few turns.
Electing to go with Siphon. I guess he wants to heal a little bit.
Yeah, it makes some sense. Like, BGH is the cheap one. It might come in handy. He saw Fugin.
That makes sense.
I would have liked to see Bran.
Yeah, if you're gonna peddler. Have we seen Healbot from Jingbudda yet?
Yeah, he played it.
Okay. He's played all of his healing then.
So he kinda needs Reno at some point soon. Or Jiraxxus maybe. So many possibilities. Yeah, Corruption's not bad, honestly.
No, I think he'll even play it.
And Belcher. Well, he saw Owl. I've got the beat. No, he didn't. Owl's in hand, though. Oh, man. It's too bad Bran didn't come down. He may have found a second Power Overwhelming, or maybe a Soulfire or something. Just really useful stuff. The way things are looking here. No one's drawing their Reno, though.
Oh! This is potential lethal, seeing
both of them. Wow. Yeah, he saw the Big Game Hunter. Well, I don't know about the Chow.
I don't either, because you just allowed him to heal out of lethal range.
Yeah.
But Jing didn't draw any real answer.
Oof. Yeah, it's rough,
so
I think.
Boom Boom with Jing... Dark Bomb, assuming the Thaddeus gets to hit, and Owl will go through the Belcher.
Yeah,
This should be the game. Unless he taps into Reno, obviously.
Jing didn't use the Siphon Soul, did he? Tap into Reno.
I thought he did. Maybe not.
And I've lost a bit of track here. Unfortunately, Thaddeus is not a demon.
He knows what he's looking for. He finds the Dark Bomb. It'll keep him alive for a turn.
Oh, yeah. Corruption.
And the zombie chow comes back to bite. Ooh.
Oh, so is Boom Boom going to be one off here?
Yeah.
Jiraxxus.
Oh no! Don't you dare play Jiraxxus.
You know, he we really might.
I know he really might. No, we're gonna see. Oh, what?
Oh yeah, you can do that.
I guess. Yeah, your opponent didn't have an answer, so.
Yeah. Now Thaddeus gets to.
Now Thaddeus gets to.
Yeah, he saw Shadow Flame. Dr. 4 comes down.
Yeah, I think Dr. 7 is just a little bit better, but you know, what do I know?
Okay, so this can be cleared. The Power Overwhelming, along with either Dark Bomb or Demon Wrath. Probably Demon Wrath.
Is there a Dark Bomb? No, there's no Dark Bomb, just Demon Wrath.
Silly.
So many possibilities. The Power Overwhelming.
Demon Wrath doesn't quite kill it. Does it?
No,
it would have one.
Oh.
So he's tapping more. Oh,
well, Argus will do it. Argus will do it.
Argus, Power Overwhelming, Demon Wrath.
Yeah. Yep, that's it. Pretty awkward to use Argus that way, but
yeah,
it works.
All of those cards to kill one card, really.
Yeah, really.
The Shredder won't even pop the first hit.
Yeah. Yeah, we did see this matchup that the Jing played Fugin. Acidic.
Yep.
He did see lots of board clears. Yeah. And yeah, Dark Bomb along with the minions, it's not going to let.
Will we see Jiraxxus here?
It's not gonna let the Thaddeus push through. I think he might play. He is low. So either I wouldn't mind Fugin and Healbot.
Yeah, that's probably better.
Fugin can become a second Thaddeus. Pretty crazy. You can Irvin too.
Interesting that he's tapping so much rather than getting out these threats. I think he wants has been green for 6 days.
I think he wants that Reno really bad. Oh, Whirling Zappo. The Demon Wrath will be pretty.
There's a look, though.
It might finally find its moment here.
Oh, that Demon Wrath is so good here.
Yeah.
And then he. Oh,
the Demon. Like, the 3/3s will live, which is unfortunate. Yeah, I think.
Now, if he Demon Wraths and then plays Lotheb.
I wonder.
Does Boom Boom play Jiraxxus? You have to be wary of. Like, you're playing a slow Hammock Mirror. You have to be thinking about that, right?
Yeah, like, maybe.
Yeah, maybe. I mean, he might not be.
Like, playing Jiraxxus early is, it's so good. It really is. But also, Dr. Boom.
Emperor, so it's a little less enticing because he can't do anything to the board.
Dr. Boom has just been rotting, like, forever. I think Dr. Boom comes down before Jiraxxus goes. You love to play a Jiraxxus behind Boom. You'd never feel better. Oh, that's good.
Very good. Now he has an answer for Dr. Boom. So still, that zombie chow has kept the game alive.
Yeah, that chow.
Oh, Boom Boom finds his own Reno.
There's Reno. I don't think he wants to tap anymore, though.
No, I don't think so.
3 cards left.
I don't know what else he could have in his deck that he's looking for. And is he gonna? I think you just go full steam ahead, right?
You saw every AoE.
Still no Reno.
I could see it either way. Siphon Imp Gang, I guess. That's it. Oh, man.
Oh, and then Jiraxxus has to be played. But you want a Reno before you Jiraxxus.
I think you kind of... I think the Fugin's really attractive, too.
Yeah, because it's a second Thaddeus.
Yeah. In fact, it's funny. Jing has exactly Stalag and Reno left in his deck. I'm pretty sure. Those are his last 2 cards. And
yeah.
I don't know what Boom Boom has.
It's all in
game. Yep.
And now, does Boom Boom kill himself?
Oh, God.
Does it happen?
Yeah, he's got a little more burst here, so he might just set up a board.
Fugin is so powerful right now.
Yeah, just set up a board and give yourself the potential to here use this dark bomb and abusive.
Oh man, Jing's gonna Reno next turn regardless, though. I don't think BoomBoom can win this game.
He knows he'll draw it. Fugan can get silenced, which is nice. Oh, I saw the mouse go over Draxus.
I think he's gonna do it! Oh, good
robot. Oh, wow. Nice bomb. He might just clear.
Oh, and it's over!
He did it.
Oh, oh Jake, you gotta start emoting.
Oh my god.
Oh.
Oh no. I mean,
Tech
he could be
Reno.
No, he could become Draxus himself if he wants, but Jing's not one for BM. He's just gonna win the game. Oh my god.
Wow. BoomBoomHall kills himself turns after playing a zombie chow, which kept his opponent alive.
That tech payoff paid off real big. It actually happened. You know, Jing told me that he did this earlier in a THL game this season. I can't remember which week, but this is not his first Drax that he's seen.
And if you're bringing Warlock at all, you have to have something with Sacrificial Pact in it.
Yeah, it's good versus any Warlock.
Yeah, like we
versus Zoo.
That. Mange and I have tested that. It's like even against an Imp Gang boss, it's just so good.
Yeah, not bad.
Yeah,
not bad at
even
all.
Even in like a Zoo mirror, because you just steal so much tempo from your opponent.
And if you want to get really adventurous, just put a Dreadsteed in your deck. Then the sparks can really fly.
So now Boom Boom has Paladin against Hunter.
Whoa! Is this the Murloc?
It might be.
Is this Murgle Paladin?
It could be.
I think it's Murgle Paladin.
He
or Arena.
He gives away True Silver against Hunter and keeps Acolyte. And I think I would have flipped that.
Yeah, off the coin it feels a little awkward,
yeah,
but
this Acolyte of Pain's almost
oh, man.
It is a Murgle Paladin!
Beautiful, beautiful hand for Jing. Wow.
Look
at Boom Boom.
Jing's got this.
Look at Boom Boom. I don't know. Like, the Murloc, the anything can happen paladins, they run two heal bots and two lay on hands. Reporting for duty. And wow, he's got two peacekeepers to look forward to things like Lotha, Pymane. Wow.
Well, he might be able to steal one here then.
This should be a really, I mean, one way or another, this match is going to be really interesting. Wow. Murloc Paladin. Never trade.
He played like Doomsayer in this deck.
Yeah, like one or two.
Holy cow.
See, alt? No, his Murloc War Leader's not gold. Shame on him. Nope. Nobody wants to trade.
I think you want to trade if you're the Paladin there, right? I guess you hope your Acolyte can hit the 1-1.
Yeah. Yeah, that makes sense. I don't know. I know the traps that Jing is running, so I don't think you want to play a freezing here.
Does that mean he's only running freezing?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, oh man, the delay is going to catch up. No, Boom Boom will no. Boom Boom's an honorable guy. I like throwing the creeper in. See what beast you get. River Croc. Yeah.
Never lucky.
It's not bad. I don't mind the freezing trap too much. At this point, like Jing's, the gears are spinning. You see Paladin play an Acolyte of Pain, and you're immediately thinking that something out of the norm is happening here. You're thinking maybe Reno, maybe Murloc. He hasn't seen a Murloc yet, but he will. If only Web Spinner gave him a Hungry Crab.
Is there any merit to just tossing out a Tempo Peacekeeper and planning on it getting Freezing Trap?
Ooh. Yeah, this poor Acolyte's probably never getting played again this game. I like the Doomsayer, actually.
Yeah, okay.
And if you're, Jing, he completely has the capability to take care of it.
Yep.
Or just go face. Yeah, I don't mind.
Yeah, he's already doing a lot of damage.
Yeah. You are a hunter. It's better to accept it.
I think Boom Boom's gonna play this Acolyte of Pain.
Oh, the hand is revealed. He has a quality of consecration to look forward to, but Lothep's gonna spoil it. And the dude's dead. He can't get frozen. I'm sure. Wow. This game's going places. But I... Oh, wow.
Oh, Jing does kill a frozen.
I think... Yeah.
I think you want that frozen, right? Because it's such a valuable combo.
Yeah. Like, it'd be good for it to freeze and just never die. It'd also be nice to get a second bow charge.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, Boom Boom probably wouldn't have given you, but... The
he
dream would...
at some point.
At some point, yeah. Yeah, so... Yeah, prioritizing squeezing in hero power is as good.
I'll show them. I'll show them all.
And actually, I'm pretty sure the scientist is useless, but it's still good to throw out. Rivercrock's nice to keep because it's enabling kill command.
This is a good concentration.
Yeah. I guess you don't really need to use equality. Leaving behind a 1-2 Lothab.
I don't like Healbot, because you're just giving the health right back.
Yeah, I would have liked Healbot more if he didn't attack, because then there'd be the threat of Healbot being frozen, and then Jing would...
Yeah, that Healbot isn't going to stall very long, because your opponent already has 7 damage. Showing.
You know, seeing from Boom Boom, I think he tried to hit the Aldor into a minion. I think he was really fishing for... fishing for snakes, yeah. Which would have been great. Not the case, though.
I wonder.
So what's the merit in trading here? Keeping just about as much board as he can. Oh, Captain. I think he was hoping for a higher quality beast. Shredder hero power is fine, but... I think he would have liked to see something better than River Croc and... Ugh, Captain's Parrot.
Another consecration. So he'll finally get to toss out this Acolyte of Pain.
It's a very expensive Acolyte.
That Peacekeeper's scary. But he has another one, I guess, for Jaime.
Yeah.
Oh, there he is!
Yep, and Jing knows he still has the expensive one, but... Like, Jing knows that if the expensive Aldor gets played, then... Not too much... else might happen.
Two health minion, that's not good for Jing.
No. Whew. Yeah, no other secret. Yeah, I think it's getting to the point now where just the heals and utility
is really starting to stabilize.
Yeah, and you know anything can happen.
Oh, old Merka.
Wow. And the Acolyte finally gets to realize his dreams of feeling the pain.
Eddie Finn!
There it is.
It can happen!
Yeah.
So now he has to toss out the Markai to get that combo lined up. Yeah, you... Trade. Yep.
You just want Markai dead.
Oh, Dr. Boom is a nice find.
Nice. It'll force an equality consecration.
Yeah. Unfortunately, Boom Boom has 2 of those, so...
Yeah, he won't be bothered.
Using one to kill off Boom and a Jaime. It's totally fine.
And unfortunately, this Hunter's Mark that Jing's got is never going to...
No.
Unless there's a second Doomsayer, which is possible.
Because there's not even Tyrion in this deck, right?
No, they can't fit in Tyrion. On top of what's normally double lay on hands and 2 anything. Like, Tyrion, obviously amazing, amazing card, but he just doesn't fit the game plan.
So, Boom Boom will equality. I think he'll trade the Acolyte first and then equality, right? Yeah.
Yeah. Just break that high main. Get those hyenas in on the consecration goodness. I think might be kind of concerned about these bombs if some of them go to face, but he has lay on hands.
Oh, true.
And true silver. She could just play this turn.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Oh, this solemn vigil. It's gonna be free.
Wow. It really will. Wow. Wow. You know, I've seen sometimes people play this deck, and they play a solemn vigil up front for, like, they'll pay 5 mana for it sometimes, but this is when you feel really good.
Another war leader.
Good thing that, oh wait, Murkai already attacked this.
It did already attack.
It's too bad. Wow, that... Now it doesn't feel good to do Houndmaster, because Murkai is guaranteed to trade, and kill commanding it for the tempo feels pretty bad.
It prolongs your doom, yeah.
I wonder. Yeah, Boom Boom only has...
The only way the Hunter can win here is by kill commanding. And
first yeah, you could do that. Yeah, Jing's not low himself, but he knows it's coming. Huh. No value ooze there. There's the second Doomsayer, though. And Paladin's got nothing like Frost Nova.
I don't think I like Lay on Hands. I think the Pyromancer Consecrate for a full clear is really good.
Yeah, it's true. Plus, what are you looking for?
Yeah, I don't know.
I guess more heals and... Like, that's just kind of what the deck does. It heals, it draws, it neutralizes threats.
Now, he doesn't have a... Oh, yeah, because he gets a bunch of Murkais, right? He'll get nothing but War Leaders and Murkais off of anything.
Yeah, yeah, no Blue Gill Warriors dead this game.
So he's got lethal, right? Or does it only bring back the one Murkai?
It'll only bring up one. Because okay. Murkai only died once this game. He stuck around for a long time. It was weird, but... Yeah, no Blue Gill Warriors. That's a shame.
So I think you're okay to True Silver and Consecrate, right?
Huh. Yeah, I don't know, actually. Oh, or just Pyro
Equality.
Yeah, Pyro Equality is nice because it's so cheap.
Another free one.
Vigil. Yeah, now he'll find those Bluegill Warriors.
Oh, keep an older one with it.
He'll play. Oh, that's a 3/3 Bluegill. Look at that. Wow. So now I think that the Anyfin might actually be lethal, because you'll get both the War Leaders back.
I think so.
You get the War Leaders, they're going to buff Bluegill up to 9 damage. And Murkai with four Murlocs on the board. Two of them...
He'd be 8, 10. Yeah, he would have lethal. He'd have 19 plus the Keeper.
Yeah, the War Leaders are terrifying. I think it's lethal. Yeah.
He knows.
Boom Boom knows. You don't bring this deck without knowing a thing or two. Oh, wait, no, it's not. Wait.
No, it's not.
No, it's not.
Oh, feels bad, man.
It's pretty close, to be fair. I guess you don't trade, though. You're not that afraid. You saw the kill command. But I think unleash kill command would have been something.
Yeah, it might have. Unleash double kill command.
Unleash kill command hero power was one off, I think. It's two cards. Wow.
Takes us to a game 5, but we're going to have Reno Warlock against a midrange hunter, and I think I favor the midrange hunter there.
Yeah, it should. Like, Reno can definitely be devastating.
Yeah, he can, like, curve out.
Yeah, that'll be the thing. For sure. If he can just... If he can hit a Zombie Chow or a Peddler... Yep. Peddler, Imp Gang Boss.
Now we got a game on our hands.
Yeah.
And the Sun Fury.
She'll hang out for her time.
And
if
Jane
you're Jane,
is on
Animal Companion is fine.
Yeah, I think the other ones have to go.
Oh, man. Yeah, this game could be...
This is a game 5 of playoffs, right here.
Yeah, Murgle Paladin gets a win, and now it's time for Reno and Midrange Hunter. Which midrange hunter's been out of the pair. Oh,
and
it keeps
both
the out.
Players drew really well, so.
Yeah. This should be a doozy.
Can't throw around too much salt.
Especially if Jing finds his way into... There you go. And maybe this game he'll get slightly better beasts off of it. I think he'd play it.
Oh, yeah.
He's just mousing over a little bit, creating some mind games for Boom Boom.
Alright, well, Jiraxxus is not going to be fighting Souls.
No. Or, oh, yeah. Yeah, Boom Boom's probably a little traumatized
with
that.
Voodoo Doctor helps you against Hunter. I think Abusive helps you trade, too, I guess.
Yeah, Abusive would help you trade into an animal companion or something. Oh man, the coin feels valuable now.
Oh, really? But
you know Web Spinner's probably dead. But yeah, you'll just curve out better if you go with Scientist now.
I wonder.
Did we see a Hunter's Mark in Jing's deck?
It was there.
Okay.
He never played it. He never played it, so Boom Boom doesn't know. But
so
he might.
In the event
he might
that Lord Jiraxxus gets taunted up, he does have the answer.
Oh, you know, but Boom Boom doesn't actually have Void Caller in his deck.
Oh, you're right. Okay.
Yeah. Oh, Web Spinner. Houndmaster feels a little more secure now.
Yeah.
You can get a freezing trap
companion here, definitely.
Yeah, getting the freezing trap feels nice, because now whatever companion is, Misha's perfect, actually. Outside of Dark Bomb Mortal Coil. I mean, could you coin out the Web Spinner? Maybe you should.
Yeah. Seems okay.
It seems pretty unlikely that both these beasts are dead next turn with the freezing trap. Oh, one's gonna be dead.
And you know that's freezing trap if you're Boom Boom.
Yeah, you do, and I don't know. Like, Argus is nice to get frozen. Farseer is okay. Sunfury would be kind of cute here.
I think you just play the Earthen Ring.
Yeah. Not a big heal, but it's something. Oh, you could taunt both these guys up.
Yeah, you could do that.
I don't see why not.
Ooh, I don't like this, though. If you're going to play Sun Fury, you need to play Abusive. Shield up!
Probably. So now...
Now you just play the Shredder, right? You know, you already have Houndmaster turns in your hand for five
I think
six.
So. Yeah. Man, Timberwolf could be really good with Unleashed down the road. These Renolocks, they can swarm the board a little bit. And you won't attack either, because then the puny imp can just get frozen. That doesn't feel good.
Oh, you don't think you will attack?
Maybe you should.
Because even if you don't, Sun Fury going back is still pretty good for the Warlock.
Yeah, that's true.
And then he can, and then he would be able to Abusive and then trade.
Right, but Jing knows that if he does trade, Boom Boom knows the freezing traps. He knows that there's no other trap in the deck.
Yeah.
So he would just, he'd freeze the imp. Or, I don't know. They're thinking about it. He does trade. Yes, no, maybe so. Wonder if he's thinking about how mastering.
Yeah.
Huh. Okay. So maybe Timberwolf's aspirations can be with Unleash the Hounds, which wouldn't normally be the most valuable thing in the deck. Do you tap?
I think you'd
rather. Or Earthen.
I think you'd rather Earthen.
Yeah, just Earthen. Fight, maggot! Because now you can actually hope to deal with. Replay the Imp?
Replaying the imp feels awful. He's playing a 3-mana 1/1.
Man, that imp has dreams.
I think you want the 3/3 over the 1/1, but
between the two of them, that's a dead Houndmaster. it's true.
Wow, that's an opinion I'd like to hear.
Now what?
I mean, I know Earthen wouldn't get full value, but
right.
You have Healbot in your hand for the healing.
Right. now these creepers come down. Which are annoying. Oh Reno, this really became a... This becomes a really different game now. With Reno... With Reno in the field now, it's... Now Boom Boom can just play however he wants.
Now he needs to find enough threats to wear out Jing's resources.
Yeah, like what Jing needed now...
He still doesn't have a high main. That quick shot doesn't feel good.
No, at least you're pushing damage. Yeah, Shredder had to be played. You have Owl and Kill Command, so if you prioritize damage a little bit, Timberwolf might even be able to help.
I think it's pretty good.
Yeah, I think so. You definitely feel comfortable tapping with Reno.
4/7 will definitely find its time, means the Hunter.
Yep. Freezing Trap's out of the way. What's bad for Boom Boom Hall is he hasn't tracked down any of these AoEs that would be so good. Yeah, that's good. Jing's clearly shown that he wants to be pushing damage, and Houndmaster will help.
He's gonna push his way right into a Molten Giant Reno.
I think he's worried about just a board clear, the way things are looking.
So many cards in the Warlock's hand, and he chose not to pop the creepers and rather use his quick shot on the 2/2 last turn, so he's got to be thinking about it.
Yeah, I think so. You could trading with Argus helps, mm-hmm. because this way with AoE, I guess what the tokens from one of the creepers and what pops from the Shredder might stay intact, depending. I don't think that kill command's going anywhere, but he's thinking about Moltons now, probably.
Yeah.
He saw Defender of Argus, and he saw Sunfury Protector, so actually, is Molten all that scary?
Here he comes!
Well, Molten plus Reno's scary. You can even tap. You can tap Molten.
Tap Molten Reno.
That's...
Oh no, do it correctly, sir!
Missed card. That card might matter.
Definitely.
Like, he's healed up, but he could use more resources.
He's gonna take
a lot
of damage this turn, too, anyway. 8, 9, 10, 11, 14.
Yeah, at this
point... 16 possible damage, but he has Earthen Ring and TKO Bot. And he's running right? I think both players are. Or both players were.
You know, I don't think we ever saw a Brand from Boom Boom, but it might have been in his deck. We didn't see a few things.
Okay. I think we might have seen it in the first game.
That's right. Yeah, I forgot this Renalux. Actually, Jing's gotten all of his wins off of this Renalux.
Yes, he has.
Now that I look down. Yeah, face is the place. Gotta punish Warlock for cheating.
Drax. Oh man, there's so much healing in Boom Boom's hand.
Yeah, I think...
Given that we still haven't seen a high main, he has Big Game Hunter for Boom. It's kind of Boom Boom's game to lose at this point.
Oh there's Bran. Alright, Bran Healbot's gotta be the... going back up to 30.
Zombie Chow with it.
Go back up to 30, what's not to love? A Doomsayer could have ruined everything.
Mm-hmm.
Everything.
So Jing can draw Unleash the Hound. Oh, and he does!
Whoa, what's this doing?
Clearing
Boom
the board.
Boom. Boom Boom didn't push any face.
No.
So, let's see. You could suicide off one spider token, and then you can get your full hounds, clear off the other spider token, and play Timberwolf.
Yeah, and clear the board.
Yeah.
Oh, but you don't want to trade into Reno.
Yeah, you can just...
I guess it doesn't matter.
Well... I guess
trading
into Molten would have been the thing to do.
That's what I was looking at. Like, trade into Molten Hounds, trade into Molten again, and then play Timberwolf.
So you miss... By missing one Hound, you lose the potential to clear everything.
Okay.
You can clear...
Space is the place.
Oh, actually, yeah, I don't mind this one bit. So in this case... In this case, 2 damage was missed.
Farseer.
Oh, yeah, Brand's still on the board.
That's another 6 healing, plus a Belcher coming down.
Yep. Oh, does Abusive change?
Does he have lethal 12?
No. If he had pushed a little previously.
He has to kill the Timberwolf.
Rexxar's all over the world are crying.
And he's got to throw out the zombie chow. Probably even the Abusive, too. You've already seen one on the board.
Probably. Maybe
well,
you
might not lose any minions, though, either.
Yeah, you need to start pushing for some damage.
He has next turn lethal.
Bam.
And I don't know if the Hunter can draw his way out of this.
No. What's King Zealot going to find?
Yeah, nothing.
Nothing.
Nothing that changes the game state.
Yeah, the
Jingbudda not finding his heavy threats really opened the door.
Yeah, no high mains, no Dr. Boom. Well, Dr. Boom wasn't going to do work with big game. Might have been something. Wow.
And choosing not to trade. Well
played. No, I just.
I don't know.
I think he
has to at least kill a Brand, right?
I think he knows he's had it this game.
And so BoomBoomHall.
Yeah.
Takes the series 3-2.
Yep.
Meaning that. I don't think it's winner take all necessarily. If Michael beats Jedi 3-2.
If
Michael beats Adam. Jedi at all, or if Adam beats Jedi at all, you guys win. So I think it's winner take all.
Oh, because we would have the majority of games won. This was 3-2, so yeah.
Yeah, so our next match, which is going to be streamed tonight, THL fam, is winner take all for the series.
Yeah, that's at 9.
Yes.
9 p.m.
The
Eastern.
First one's at 9 p.m., right? I think we have 2 matches that are
Oh, first one's going to be at 8.
Okay, so we have 2 matches starting at 8 p.m. Eastern, and the second one is winner take all in this series. Can Gosu be dethroned in round 1? Tune in to find out. But this is all we have right now, so we're going to sign off and give you guys a few hours to finish up your Sunday festivities, and then we'll see you right back here, because it's been an exciting first week, and it's going to come to an epic conclusion. So we will talk to you guys.